नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स वन एंड ऑल इन रेस्पेक्टिव डोमेन्स। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट आर द काइंड ऑफ डिफिकल्टीज दैट citizen as an individual is facing and what is happening in media and news. If one is thinking from the TRP point of view, it's not going to really help the individual by any means at first place. This is valid and very much in reference to be it fine arts and culture, schools, colleges, institutions, research methodologies, scientists, bureaucrats, and celebrities, diplomats, what not, everyone. There are certain things which I feel we are missing, and in fact we are missing. One is the point of focus or the focal point of understanding the needs and necessities has been missing for quite a long time, and it is being going on and on for centuries and years and years. Unemployment rate is increasing, employability levels have decreased, what not, everything. The reasons are misogynistic attitude, attitudinal issues, favorism, nepotism, what not, everything. And that is the reason why rich is becoming richer, poor is becoming poorer. And the quality of education that is being imparted or imbibed into the minds of the individuals right from his or her childhood is, he or she needs to be collector or chartered accountant or CFA, or you need to have money, you need to have this bank balance to have that false dignity. This I have been seeing for quite a long time in my 45 years time, almost close to 25 years. This insane attitude of illusionary accumulation of thought process in the individual's mind is corrupting his or her brains. How do we address this? Today, sad part is that we are not understanding the practical importance of it. Sad, but truth has to be told. As per census of 2017, 26.30% of the population, billion population, are illiterates. And 0.044% of them are literate without formal education. 21.78% are below primary education. 16.18% of the billionth population are middle education. 11.14% are secondary education. 6.21% are higher educations. 1.28% of them are diploma or the certificate holders. 7.96% are graduation and above. 7.96% are graduation and above. How do we think with these stats, with these numbers which I have given, are really going to make India a supernatural power? The same thing, if I go with the philosophy and spiritual approach, right from Indic culture, Indus Valley civilization, Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Gupta and Maurya civilization, it's totally different from what exactly these numbers are. These numbers were quite double of what exactly I am speaking about. During that period of time, the education system was totally different. It had a scheme, it had a structure. What is that one structure or one scheme that we are establishing today as an individual? And my question to diplomats, bureaucrats, celebrities, billionaires, arabpatis, millionaires, when there is so much poverty, when an individual is not having one square meal per day, he is not able to have one square meal per day, how are you guys able to buy those extravaganza cars? How are you able to accumulate that wealth? From where are you getting all this wealth? And what has happened to the income tax paid by the employees of the multinational companies who have been employed by the employer? Where is that money going? Are the debates, are the discussions that are happening across media, be it Facebook, be it LinkedIn, be it anything, are for TRP ratings? Are you really addressing anyone as such? I am asking you, as a part of responsible citizen. In fact, I have lost faith in corporate governance or the governance for a simple reason, that they mock or they talk all nonsense, which I have been seeing from past 5 years or 6 years, which is impacting the society. and the society from the societies, it is going to middle class families, lower middle class families, upper middle class families. Forget about the poor. They don't really have anything and they don't even care. For them, if they have one meal per day, that's enough, they can sleep. Someone who is having formal education with very good understanding about the subject and the civilization or the society part of thing, he is the sufferer. Number of IITians, number of students. In fact, of late, dancers too came into this camp, unable to manage the pressure. They learn the art and art form. They try to do something, but not everyone is paid. They are exploited. They are explored over the negative aspect of it. And they are getting used to that. How are we addressing this to the art and culture format? And how do you expect individuals to understand the social and the economic ethos by and large? Today, forget about this pandemic attack. Even before, when this pandemic attack was not there, unemployment was existing. It was not as it is today. Number of people who are unemployed today are in lakhs. They do something or the other by taking loans. In the end, they end up not getting any result out of it. How are we addressing this? We do not have any definite structure part. And the value add is missing. What kind of value adds that teachers are giving today? I would want to know. The only kind of value add that teachers are giving is false pomp. I have been to one of the schools. I have seen they talk as if they are what you call professionals in English, stylishly, but they never knew that English is all about just for communication. For that matter, even Hindi, whatever language it is. Why are we giving that examples, those examples? What is it that we are addressing towards today? This I had to speak because I was forced to speak. I was forced. I was questioned on, you have not been earning for 5 years. Is the money important for everyone? Why this question has arisen is what I really pondered out of my research, speaking to people. What I have understood is that 2 or 3 out of 10 members get whatever they want or get to the fullest. Out of the rest 7, they are exploited. They are either ridiculed, they are either discouraged. And this leading to dissatisfaction. I am telling 3 out of 10. If I calculate 10 power 100, 10 power 1000 or 1000 power 10, approximate figure. If I take the realistic figure and actual figures, the one who is watching my video right now will not have words to express. Why politicians are not addressing this today? Why individuals are not addressing this today? I am talking individuals in various domains. Specifically educational field. And specifically art and culture. Because art and culture is very much related to philosophy and spirituality of the personal individuals as a single entity. And this is the direct means to understand our civic sense, social sense. Have we ever tried to address this? This is a direct open-ended question to every scholars in art and culture, fine arts and culture, in universities. And this is a direct question to the teachers in the schools, colleges and institutions that they are running. And it's a direct question to corporate governance. Chief operating officers or the highest level of people. I'm asking a direct question. Are we getting to understand the gist of the philosophy and the spirituality aspect over here, which was prophesized in fact, in the Vedic books and Upanishads? Maybe I might be rude, I might be upfront, I might be blunt. And this is a direct question to the people, individuals, who are questioning others, inability of not getting employment opportunities, or who are facing employment issues, and you are questioning him and you are pressurizing him. It could be anyone. Have you ever understood what exactly is happening in between all of these lines? In the last 3 or 4 years of my experience in my research field, which I was doing in fine arts and culture, what I have understood is that there is a strong misinterpretation of the conceptual understanding of Vedas and Upanishads. Forget about the entertainment part. Fine arts and culture, schools, colleges, institutions, spiritual institutions, philosophical institutions, these are the pillars for everything. If we are giving it a proper structure and proper scheme to the way that we are producing this, this critical question could have an answer. Is there someone who can answer me all these questions? I dare challenge every research scholar in from these six domains and talk to me or my group that I have and convince me on one aspect that you have developed, you have thought about it. Shastras or Natya Shastra, Shastra or Natya Shastra is not about the doctrine, about the dance or anything like that. It is equally important to understand from the philosophy and spiritual front the social status or the political status. How you are developing that, how you are creating that pillar. How many of us really understood that? If it is streamlined at this level, then the political diplomats, actors, celebrities will automatically come online. And that is one reason why this is considered divine. Have we ever understood Shastras or whatever it is from this point of view and try to address this? Today, the unemployment or the employability would not, question of unemployment or the question of inability of the employable person of learning this art form would not have arisen. Forget about whether he or she gets money or not. But we need to think about it. It's high time. And coming to the politicians, bureaucrats, diplomats, what is it that they are doing to really understand this? How are they streamlining all of this? What are the steps that they are taking towards creating that renaissance, which will be the next step towards the growth of employment or the employability? Question of unemployment will not arise. Understand this. It has a very deeper and in-depth study, sir. Friends, one and all. This is a very specific open-ended question for scholars in the field of art and culture. in the field of education department. It could be any kind. And if this is being put across to the bureaucrats, politicians, or top level ministers, what are the ministers doing about it? What are they thinking about it? It's a $1,000 billion question. Thus, I conclude this video with a note that this is an open-ended question which needs to be addressed by and large across all domains. The specifically these six domains which holds the key. Directly as well as indirectly talking about how this issue was dealt during the pre-medieval times, Indic culture, Indus Valley civilization, Harappa, Mohenjo-daro time. Thus I conclude this video. Please think about it. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Sri Guru Brahma. Have a nice day.